just reaching for a BXX 14 oversized cable entry. Well, I'm back at work after 4 months of Sundays. It's quite strange, I'm in an empty warehouse and I thought I'd show you how to make off a DMX cable. This is tough old stuff, that cable, with a braided shield, which I watch me as I unpick, and I'll solder a piece of wire to it to make the connection with. It's my preferred way. You can just use a stiffened bit of the silver wire and solder it plain, or put a bit of sleeve over it. I don't think it's quite as tough as doing it this way. And being tough is what we're all about. Anyway, I'm in an empty workshop. I'm here on my own. Normally there's four or five magicians working our magic on the equipment that comes back off hire and the stuff that needs repairing to be put back out. It's sad. I've never seen an empty warehouse like we have at the moment. It's stuffed with all the kit you can see, and it's empty of people. Soldering that, and you notice I've got a good fume extractor going there. It really helps. I can tell you 50 years of soldering, it really does mash your lungs up, those fumes. Trimming it down. I'm sorry about the camera shot, it's just a camera perched on my bench at an awkward place. And I need. Don't mind me singing along to the radio. By the way, I am Bernice. I work here at Neg Earth Lights, although in the past 35 years I have worked for many companies in the rock and roll stage lighting and sound industry. I'm now trimming off the bits of ropey stuff that run down the cable. I'm afraid it's out of shot. It's my bad. No problem. The tassel's out the way. And I use a little bit of heat shrink. I can use a Hellermann sleeve or something like that. So I find a bit of glue lined heat shrink is absolutely superb on here. It seals up the end nicely, so even when the connector is totally trashed and waterlogged, the cable's still good when you cut it free. I'm now trimming the ends, and I will be tinning them in a moment. So I say it's really eerie. I've walked through a completely void of people's warehouse. Cables piled high in all the stillages and no one working, which this time of year is just wrong. Usually we've got gigs coming in, gigs going out, festivals, tours, the whole issue.
Okay, we're tinning the buckets in the 5-pin connector. Nice new one here. pin 1, pin 2. Oops, a little too far from the extractor, which is going strong there. Pin 3. Pin 4. And pin 5, making sure that each one is filled from the bottom upwards. Comes our screen wire, a bit of wire I've soldered to the braid on the outside. On it goes. Pin 2. That would be DMX negative signal. And of course it don't want to go in. Go straight in so you can tie it up. Pin 3, that's the DMX positive signal. And pin 4, which is negative, the second pair of signals that I don't think I've ever seen used on anything. And pin 5. And soon we'll be ready to test it. That's turned round. I've already plugged that end into my scope and I've put a short on the end. And I'm measuring its length. Put test for polarity, that's correct. And my terminator turned round, which shows me all both lines are functioning
perfect.
Now all we have to do is mark it up.
Brand tape.
Just made. Yellow heat shrink marker showing our cruise that it's a 5-pin DMX lead. And now, for one of the most important skills anybody in this industry should have. To coil the lead properly under and over, and we don't always get it right first time. I always coil from the male end. one turn of tape is all it takes. The next person to use this cable will just want to pull it apart and fling it out. And on with the next one, and I'm reaching for the last of another VXX14